So far, in this course, we have learnt about several processes and memory structures. In this session, let's recap all the concepts which we have learnt so far. For that, I have put together a transaction flow which will show you what happens when a transaction is executed in the database. Okay? If you look at the diagram, we have our database files, the redo log files, and then we have our background processes. The database writer, log writer, checkpoint, system monitor, and process monitor. And within the shared global area, we have our rollback segment, shared pool, database buffer cache, and redo log buffer. Here, a user is executing a update statement. He is executing update customer set name equal to John, where customer ID equal to 12345. Now let's see what happens whenever this SQL statement is executed. As soon as user submits the SQL statement, the connection to the server is established, the program global area is allocated, and the statement is sent to the server. You see, the user process is created. So now, in the second step, the server checks the shared pool for a parsed statement. It checks to see if a similar statement is already parsed and present in the shared pool. If it is parsed, it will use that parsed statement. Otherwise, the statement is parsed and stored in the shared SQL area. Okay, that's the second step. Now, in the third step, the statement is executed. The server reads the data from the data files into the database buffer cache. You see, the data from the data files is taken by the process and stored in the database buffer cache. That's the third step. Now, the fourth step. The server makes the change to the block in the database buffer cache. Since we wanted to change the name to John and this is the block which needs to be updated, the server made the changes to the block in the database buffer cache. That's the fourth step. Now, in the fifth step, whatever the changes were made to the database buffer cache, those changes are written into the redo log buffer. Okay? And in the sixth step, the undo information, that means the data blocks before they were modified are sent to rollback segment and stored over there. Okay? Now, in the seventh step, changes to the rollback segment are recorded in the redo log buffer. And then in the eighth step, the user will get a message saying the update has been successfully completed. And then in the ninth step, the user issues a commit statement. That means the user wants to permanently save the updated changes. So, once the user issues an update, the log writer takes the redo information and stores it in the redo log files. That's the 10th step. In the 11th step, the user will get a message saying the commit is successful. And then later on, in the 12th step, the database writer takes the modified blocks present in the database buffer cache and writes them to the database files. Okay? You see how the Oracle database step by step performs various operations as soon as a transaction happens. If necessary, revisit this video again so that you understand this step by step. Okay?